Hi, everyone. Welcome to our TechBit series covering the Sophos Transparent Authentication Suite, also known as STAS. The first part provides an overview of the basic network setup, detailing the role of STAS and how it functions. The next part covers the STAS installation and configuration steps in Sophos Firewall. Let's get started. STAS simplifies user authentication by allowing automatic login to Sophos Firewall whenever users sign into their Windows Active Directory or AD workstations. The software is installed on AD servers only, so there's no need for additional software on individual workstations. To begin, I'll review a typical network setup. This example includes the Active Directory Domain Controller, or ADDC. This is where the STR agent is installed. If the network has multiple domain controllers, the agent must be installed on each one. Next is the Windows server, which is where the STA collector is installed. Then there's the AD workstation. And finally, the Sophos firewall. Now, let's take a closer look at how STAS works. STAS consists of two components, the agent and the collector. These can be installed on the same server or separate ones depending on the setup. For larger networks, multiple agents and collectors can be deployed to scale up. In this example, separate servers are used for each component. Together, the agent and collector detect user logons in three ways. I'll explain the two common scenarios in detail, logon type 2 and type 1. Logon type 3 is the third method available in STAS 2.5 and later. This is specific to environments where the agent is installed on a server that is not the domain controller. For more information about this type, refer to the link documentation. The default detection method is logon type 2. Here, the STA agent monitors the ADDC for a Windows logon event, in this case, event ID 4768. When detected, the agent sends the login details to the collector on UDP port 5566. The collector analyzes the logon event. If the user is a new STAS live user, it forwards the user information to the Sophos firewall on UDP port 6060. However, if they are an existing STAS live user, the user info does not need to be sent to the firewall. Sophos firewall then looks up the username in the ADDC to retrieve the group, email address, and other user details. Then, the user will be displayed on Sophos firewall as an STAS live user. If a user is not detected with logon type 2, STAS will attempt logon type 1. In logon type 1, the STA collector helps Sophos firewall retrieve the username from the AD workstation. For example, here a user logs on. Sophos firewall shows no live user, but the firewall rule requires user authentication for traffic from that workstation. Sophos firewall queries the collector at UDP port 6677, asking for the username on the workstation. The collector communicates with the workstation using the defined workstation polling method. For example, this could occur with WMI. Note, RPC, RPC Locator, DCOM, and WMI services should be enabled on workstations for WMI registry read access. The workstation replies with the username, then the collector records the live user and sends the information back to Sophos firewall on UDP port 6060. Sophos firewall then looks up the username in the ADDC to retrieve the group, email address, and other user details. And now, the user appears on Sophos firewall as an STAS live user. And that wraps up our overview of the basic network setup and role of STAS. I hope you found this useful. Continue to the next part of this series for the STAS installation and configuration steps. All relevant documentation for this TechBit is linked in the description. For further assistance, view and post questions on community.sophos.com and go to techbits.sophos.com for more great videos like this one.